When you think about product launch, I think some of the things we've noticed over the course of the show is that a lot of people try to follow to John's point too, is like the very linear path. And it's like there's a straight line to success. In the Amazon ecosystem, I don't know if that line is not straight. So many product launches fail, and so many sellers fail in general on Amazon, because there's always one foot. They have one foot in the pool. Like they're not willing to jump all the way in and say, here's the 10,000 or 20,000 or 5,000, whatever the number is. And it's like, that money's gone. Like, I'm gonna commit everything to launching this product, and here's exactly how I'm gonna do it. And if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But I am confident I'm gonna put my best foot forward to do this and commit to launching a product, whichever one it is.
The biggest, most common misstep that the everyday seller makes, they'll get their data, they'll look at where an opportunity might exist. They never ask the most critical question, which is, why is my product, this product, going to win against a sea of other products that are exactly like it? So I use this example all the time. It's sort of one of those ones that a few years ago popped up when you go to viral launch or you're looking for products to launch. It would kick out like a lemon squeezer was a good opportunity, right? But lemon squeezers are ubiquitous by their nature. They just sort of look the same. Maybe some have like a ceramic coating on them and some are stainless steel, but they're basically the same product. Okay, so if you just pull one off the shelf and you try to be one of 80 lemon squeezers, without any key differentiators as to why yours is special, then you're setting yourself up for a likely failure, right? So for me, there's the idea that like, I'm gonna make my lemon squeezer special. I'm gonna reinforce the hinges so I can squish a watermelon, right? And then I'm gonna call it like whatever, the gorilla squeezer, I don't know, some ridiculous name or something. Or I'd put a design on it, or I'd make it a two-pack, or I'd make it something that makes this thing special. So it just captures the attention and the sort of the intent of the consumer as they're scrolling through. So that's one thing I always do when I go to launch a product, is I write a little thesis out of like, why is this product gonna win? And yes, all of the other cogs, data and potential profit, all that stuff, of course, matters just the same. But if you don't have that piece, then you're missing out. Sellers will look to something that makes them feel good about themselves to sell, right? So they'll want to have a product that maybe has some coolness to it, or like a coolness factor, when the riches are really in the niches, right? There's all of these areas on Amazon that are completely not glamorous. And I use this example all the time. I know someone who made a ton of money selling toilet gaskets. There's nothing special about that. You don't even want to tell people at a dinner party, like, what do? I sell toilet gaskets, you know? Like, obviously not the most exciting. But what he found was like, no one was really selling these things. And the ones who were not doing a good job at it. And if I could just go get these little nibbles, I'll launch 300 of these nibbles. And by the way, for most of his time, he didn't even run PPC on the products. Mm-hmm. It was just filled this specific need that was niche. It would do like $5,000 a month. He'd make his nice 35% profit. And he found his way to humbly build, I think at the time before he sold it, a $25 million business, right? So for me, it's like, it's circumventing that, like, hey, I'm gonna get rich quick here. I'm gonna go boom, and I'm gonna start selling on Amazon. No, I'm gonna go get these little humble wins, and I'm gonna scale up and get to a place over a few years where I really find success.
Yeah.
And it was like, I think Bill Gates asked Warren Buffett once, he was like, why doesn't everyone just copy you, right? You're the most successful investor of all time. And Warren, I'm paraphrasing, but he basically said that like, everyone's too interested in getting rich quick. No one wants to do it the boring way. So I would say, look to the boring way and have a real reason as to why your product might or might not be successful.